Thank you. cavalieri. Pieghiam la mente e il cor, amato tini cantici, socri al divin fatto.
Thank you. maestà, n'avrai conforto.
Che farò, ma pur t'apagherò. Sai che nelle vila il genitor m'acconsentì ad amaro quando al campo volai. Ieri alla tarda sera, qui giunto con mia schiera, vien dolorosa idea. Vuol padre,
dicea,
sospira e levira a talmo cavaliero, e sovra il cor non va paterno impero.
Ci calma, amico.
Duol che al cor mi fiamma, sol cal m'avrà, sol cal m'avrà. Nel sonno della tomba.
Thank you.
Thank you. Oh, compia senza me. Merce di questo voglio, voi sino al tempio libero passo avrete. Tu mi accompagnerai. Oh, nobil dama, l'alto anglican sovrano parlamento ti chiama al suo cospetto. Io ti son scorta.
E che sento? E che si vuol da me? Mi aspiri morta.
A me s'addice obbedir e tacer, altro non lice.
Ed è stuardi amica?
È prigioniera da molte lune. E fu da mia creduta amica de stuardi, e messaggera sotto mentito nome.
Io che ascolto deciso il suo fato, e se perduta o sventurata.
E mia cara quel volto!
Oh figli, arrivo alle pompose teste s'appresti ognuno. Le veste fa uniretta indossar ite voi seco fuori nel vallo i miei destriesi an presti la nostra andata c'è forza da affrettar
Thank you. testa d'una felice, un bianco bel s'addice. A me non già.
Arresta, è chiaro don del ciel, così una volta deluderai la vigilante scolta. Tu mia sposa parrai, vieni.
Che dici mai? Tu corri a tua ruina, hai infame assurdo.
Vieni, vieni per pietà, ti vola a certa morte.
Con lei so entrai,
canto.
Thank you. cries of consternation and revenge at the end of Act One of I Puritani by Vincenzo Bellini. The treacherous Arturo has escaped with the royalist Queen Enriqueta, leaving his bride-to-be Elvira distractedly picking apart her bridal bouquet and discarding shoes, headdress and wedding gown in her despair and madness. A huge roar from the audience here at Covent Garden for four of the principal singers: June Anderson as Elvira, Giuseppe Sabatini as her lover Arturo, Dmitry Hvorostovsky as the Puritan Ricardo, and Robert Lloyd as Elvira's uncle Giorgio. Anne Mason sang the part of Queen Enriqueta, Mark Beasley was Lord Walton, and Ramon Remedios, Sir Bruno, with the chorus and orchestra of the Royal Opera House, chorus master Terry Edwards, leader John Brown. The performance tonight's conducted by Daniel Legati, and he'll be coming back into the pit in half an hour to conduct Act Two.
Thank you. Morte, 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 morte
fato. Dall'Anglican sovrano parla lento. Ecco il suo fato.
A voi proclama il Parlamento e a primi onor lo chiama.
Mio padre! Thank you.
fallo.
Mi sa vuol muovere Thank you.
Patria, Vittoria, e Onor, country, victory and honour. The guiding principles of Ricardo and Giorgio, alias Dmitry Vorostovsky and Robert Lloyd, for just taking a curtain call at the end of Act 2 of I Puritani by Vincenzo Bellini here at the Royal Opera House, Covent Garden. I can't resist one of George Bernard Shaw's comments. What a boon this duet must be to clamorers for melody. But I'll pause for a moment because here's June Anderson as Elvira. Dressed in white, as if at the altar, said Roger Parker's surtitles for that mad scene earlier in the act.
Ramon.
Canzon d'amore, Elvira, Elvira, come t'aggiri tu? Nessun risponde.
Così cantava di queste selve tra le dense fronde e tu allora ecco facevi alla canto mio te si ascoltasti l'amoroso canto o di quel dell'esilio già lontani.
Perché me non posso porre il piede dentro la dorate soglie di Elvira, il mio duomo.
Ah no, perder potrei me stesso, e lei
or si ripigli il canto, forse a me verrà se al cor le suona come nei dì felici, quando uniti dicemmo.
Io t'amo.
piedi tuoi, Elvira, mi perdono.
Thank you. dici?
Così come tu mi guardi, mi guarda Nessi, e intende il mio salmo, il mio parlor, il tuo, la ferma.
Ti scuoti, o certo, la dici?
Arturo and Elvira are reunited. Ricardo's murder attempt is foiled, and there's general rejoicing. Love triumphs over hatred, despite the pressures of military and religious differences. Curtain goes up on the chorus of Puritans, soldiers, men-at-arms, women, and pages. Their chorus director's Terry Edwards. He's recently been working in Chicago with the Chicago Symphony Chorus on concerts and recordings of Verdi's Otello. You can judge, I suppose, by the warmth of that applause, that that's Robert Lloyd, who sang Giorgio, a familiar figure to British audiences. Dmitry Hvorostovsky, the young Siberian baritone, making his Royal Opera House debut as Ricardo. He, of course, won the Singer of the Year competition in 1989. Arturo, sung by Giuseppe Sabatini, who, strangely enough, began his career as a double bass player. He's now, of course, specializing in high tenor roles, and was first heard earlier this season in Verdi's Rigoletto here at the Covent Garden. And Elvira, June Anderson, the American soprano, told us last week that she's only ever had one singing teacher, and that a private one. She doesn't believe in the college system for singers. the four principal singers, taking the parts originally taken by Giulia Grisi, Giovanni Ribrini, Antonio Tamburini, and Luigi Lablanche in Paris in 1835. And June Anderson encouraging Daniele Gatti, the young Italian conductor who's been in the pit this evening, and also making his Opera House debut in this run of performances. He started at La Scala only 4 years ago, and last year made his American debut at the Chicago Lyric Opera. He's due to conduct at the Deutsche Oper Berlin and at the Met in New York soon. A nice gesture that, Giuseppe Sabatini, passing one of the flowers being thrown onto the stage to June Anderson. I wonder what happened after that in the story. History doesn't relate whether Arturo and Elvira really did live happily ever after. June Anderson was suggesting at the study day last Saturday that it wasn't so much Elvira who was mad, but Arturo for persisting in wanting to marry her. Okay, that was the fourth performance of the run. There are four still to go, and Sumijo takes over the role of Elvira. And it's the first relay under a new agreement between the BBC and the Opera House, which will bring a dozen or so operas per year live on Radio 3 from Covent Garden. Our next relays on Wednesday, the 1st of July, for Wagner's Der Fliegende Holländer. And as the curtain curls go on, I'm sure that's time for us to say goodnight from the Royal Opera House, Covent Garden. Good night.